Does God care for us? Does He care about us? Of course you will say, yes, Father, of course He does. But then, what's going on today? Why does He chastise us? Which is worse, mankind devastated by a plague, or mankind that does not know how to turn to God? Now, just between you and me, we deserve it, right? Stay with me, and you'll find out more. Salve Maria. Welcome back to our Sunday Reflections. Today, we are in the third Sunday of Ordinary Time, and we see the prophet Jonah, who is called by God to announce to Nineveh that Nineveh would be destroyed in 40 days. And he goes to Nineveh, 3-day journey to cross Nineveh, and he proclaims, in 40 days, Nineveh will be destroyed. The Ninevites, they heard his voice. They heard his warning. And our Lord gave them graces by which they repented. They did penance. And from the very king to the very last one, and even to the animals, they did a public fasting, asking pardon. And our Lord forgave them. He repented of the evil that he had decided to do to Nineveh. Now, is today's world better than Nineveh? Nineveh was a pagan city with horrible sins. Today's world is, you might say, an ex-Catholic world in the West with sins much worse than Nineveh. People have turned their back to God. And it is sad to say, if we look at the church, the mystical spouse of our Lord Jesus Christ, the church which is immaculate, but the church which is called to show us the way, how many times in our days has the church become silent? Professor Plinio, my father and founder, he used to say, speaking of the crucifixion of our Lord, earthquake that shook everything and the constructions of Jerusalem falling to pieces and the darkness that overcome the whole world upon our Lord's crucifixion was nothing in comparison to the veil of the temple that was torn from top to bottom. The veil of the temple was made of wool. It was one piece that was a yard thick, a meter thick. Such was this masterpiece of wool. When our Lord died on the cross, that veil of the temple was torn, but was wrought from top to bottom. How despisable is a virus, a plague that overcomes the whole world in comparison to the crisis in which is the Holy Catholic Church, our mother. When God is going to chastise, He's going to punish a city like Nineveh. First, He sends His prophets to call them to repentance, to show them the ways. And at the same time, He sends His graces for them to repent. He wants to save them. He is not indifferent to all the horrendous sins of Nineveh, and much less of the horrendous sins of our days. Our Lord, in His kindness and mercy, He has to, for His own glory, He has to send a punishment to put things back in order. Now, before doing so, He will send us His prophets to call us, to show us the way. He wants to save us. He wants us to participate in His glory. He chastises out of love. St. Paul will tell us today, the time is running out. So those who participate in the world should participate in it, not fully. Those who buy should live as if they had nothing. Those who sell should also live as if they have nothing. And thus, take distance from a world that has turned its back to God. Our Lord will say, He will come, He will bring us in the gospel today. He will bring us the solution. The time has come. The time for the rain has come. Convert and believe in the gospel. Believe in Him. Turn to Him. What is worse? Mankind desolated, devastated by a plague, or mankind that turns its back to God? God calls us. The time has come. Convert and believe in the gospel. His Holy Mother, Our Lady in Fatima, after foreseeing tremendous days, she proclaimed that in the end, her Immaculate Heart will triumph. Let us believe, let us have confidence in this triumph. Let us confide in her, and we will have the grace of seeing the triumph of her Immaculate Heart. Let us therefore raise up our heads and with joy turn to her, ask pardon for our sins, and even if in the tremendous days that are to come, even if this may fall upon us, let us love God's adorable justice. Let us adore His justice that punishes us because of our sins. And let us ask Him in His mercy that we may, standing, contemplate the glory of the triumph of His Mother's Immaculate Heart. Of course, where her Immaculate Heart triumphs, our Lord's Sacred Heart will triumph also. May this triumph begin in your heart, and may it grow today. Start today and grow to an infinite glory. Here on earth, contemplating her glory, and above all, in heaven. For this intention, I give you my blessing. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Salve Maria.